one of the quicker free kicks you'll ever see from the off. And he looks in a little bit of discomfort. So Gabon, already with one or two injuries and a suspension, down to 10. As effectively, the game restarts. Let's hope the ice pack does the trick. So difficult for both sides to settle into a rhythm after a beginning like that. First touch for Evono. Way over the head of Obiang, who is the main man up there. Obiang. Gabon have powerful, pacey strikers, but they do need the right kind of service. The men in the red looking well prepared to deal with that, though, dropping off and off. Huang Seiko. Up and out, helped on its way by Ki Seong-yong. And time for me to bring in our match commentator at Wembley, Martin Fisher.
And still the treatment continues for Merlin Tanjigora. Forward by Nzambe. Here's Kim Bo-kyung. Just joined Cardiff City over the summer months for a fee in the region of £2.5 million, the Korean number seven. Tanjigora back on, and a warm round of applause around the stadium. But he's not moving that cleverly, is he? It's a case of needs must for Gabon. Long searching ball, and there might be an opportunity here. Well, the effort in the end from Park Chu-young lacked any great belief, really. Didn't really get hold of it. That's a simple enough stop for the Gabon keeper, Evono. An early warning for Gabon, because that was straightforward, a long boot down the centre of the field, and an opportunity at the end of it. Park Chu-young, who was on target for Korea in their win against Switzerland. Plays his club football just across the way from here in at Arsenal. This is bad. Tanjigora down again. He is in agony. And out comes the threat. Out comes the stretcher. Oh, this is a severe blow already for Gabon, who've got it all to do anyway. And now they've lost one of their key players. Merlin Tanjigora plays his club football in France. The first player from the National Football Academy in Gabon to join a European club. And Bruno has lost him for this fixture. And by the looks of things, even if Gabon make it through against the odds to the latter stages, I very much doubt whether Tanjigora would be fit enough to play in a quarter-final, which comes up in such a short space of time, of course. A couple of days between every fixture. That's Alexander Ndumbu, who also plays in France for Marseille. He warms up, ready to come on. An enforced change for Gabon. That's a decent flick on. Aubameyang wouldn't quite sit for him. And quickly back was Huang Seok-ho to snuff out the threat. But again, just as Correa almost had an opportunity with a long punt downfield, so too Gabon. Ball has gone out. Didier Avono, the captain, who is the first choice for the senior team as well. Kim Bo-kyung. Koo Jae-chul. Good closing down by Gabon. This is Kim Jung-kwon. South Korea, one of three qualifiers from the Asian Football Confederation, beat Jordan, Oman, Qatar and Saudi Arabia to book their place here. Park Jong-woo. Koo Jae-chul. Now Yoon Suk-young up from the back, being hassled away by Undong, and then a disappointing ball into the middle. Koo Jae-chul, who plays for Augsburg in Germany. And the coach, Hong Myung-bo, who has graduated to the under-23 coach, having worked with the under-20 side. He took them to the quarterfinals of the World Cup some 2 years ago. And it was after that that he graduated to the under-23 squad. Yoon Suk-young. Hwang Seok-ho. Kim Chang-soo. Gabon, the surprise winners of the inaugural African Under-23 Championships, beating hosts Morocco 2-1 in the final. And on comes Alexander Ndumbu. Started the previous two games, so it shouldn't take him long to pick up the pace of this contest. Can he make the most of this opportunity that is somewhat unexpected? Being asked to play in the centre of midfield, it means now that Gabon have two players in there that aren't regularly used in that zone of the park. And Bonga is usually a right back, and Ndumbu usually a right winger. Kim Chang-soo. Strong challenge and a foul challenge by Stevie Nzambi. Coming in strongly here, the ball had long since gone. Nzambi has only had 5 minutes previous experience. That was late on against Mexico. In for the injured Henri Ondon. And two squeals of anticipation from the Korean supporters inside this magnificent stadium. It's Ki Sung-hyung over this. Came off the wall and brings us our first corner. Ki Sung-young of Celtic. He will take the resultant corner. Gabon have brought everybody back to defend this. It's an outswinger and cleared from underneath his own bar. The header was from Kim Young Kwon. Not sure if it was going in or just heading wide, but Dindo wasn't to know that. The youngest player in the Gabon team, just 16 years of age. Played at left back in the game against Mexico, but he's been asked to play central defence today. And here come Korea with a great opportunity. Good save of Ono. Koo Jae-chul denied. Gabon have understandably been rocked by the withdrawal of Merlin Tanjigora with that injury. Their central midfield is not clicking at all. It was Engonga caught in possession. And when the opportunity fell Koo Jae-chul's way, he hit the target, but hit the palms of Didier Ovono. He could be a busy man today, the Gabon goalkeeper. That's a lovely reverse ball, Kim Byo-kyung. Good tackle though by Busugu. That's a sorry sight of Merlin Tanjigora hobbling to take his place in the dugout. It was a hard enough task at kickoff. It's been made even more difficult now with Tanjigora no longer on the pitch. Remember, Gabon not only have to win this game, but they've got to win by two to knock South Korea out and push themselves into the last eight. Yun Suk Young, Kim Young Kwon. Park Jong-woo. South Korea unbeaten at under 23 level in 17 matches. And of those 17, they've won 12. Their last defeat, by the way, came in November 2010. It was the semi-final of the Asian Games. They lost the semi-final after extra time to the United Arab Emirates. Of course, a lot of players have moved on from this level since then, but the bulk of the team is still the same. Of course, in the Olympic Games, they're boosted by three overage players, which just lend a hand and a bit more experience. They've just got the two, though. Jung Sung-ran, the goalkeeper, and Park Chu-young. Ndumbu. Baek Sung-dong. Quickly in was Engonga. Good strong run too. Over Mayang, stopped in his tracks. Swiftly in was Huang Seok-ho. Over Mayang, he was very quiet in the defeat against Mexico. They need a big performance from him. This is Nzambe. Now Madinda. Careless. Kim Bo-kyung. Now the captain, Ku Jae-chiel. Yun Suk-young. Confident run. Was blocked by Emmanuel Ndong. Referee well positioned to see that. Didn't see it as a foul, but he has blown for that. Gabon, an emerging power in African football. They've never made it through to the World Cup finals as yet, but there is a feeling that that won't be long in coming. Reached the quarterfinals of the last Africa Cup of Nations. They were joint hosts of that. Lost their quarterfinal on penalties to Mali, having won all three of their group games. Just joined us, the big news so far is the injury to Merlin Tanjigora in the opening seconds, literally from the kickoff. Barged to the ground, landed awkwardly, damaged his back, and was quickly subbed. And bearing in mind that Gabon are already without the suspended Henri Ndong and three others that would have been first-choice players, but for their clubs not releasing them, it just makes the task that much difficult for Gabon, who have to win and by two clear goals to make the quarterfinals. Otherwise, it's Korea who go through to the last eight. Yun Suk-young. Kim Bo-kyung. Far side is Kim Chang-so, driving that goalwards, on target but safe enough for Didier Avono. Kim Chang-so, one of the four players in this Korean side that play in the domestic league. The rest dotted about the globe, three in Japan, two in England, one in China, one in Germany. Axel Meyer. Away by Huang Suk-ho. Obiang. A groan of disapproval as Obiang fails to execute a five-yard pass. And Ngonga. First real touch for Jung Sung-ryong. Vastly experienced, played in all four of Korea's World Cup games in 2010 in South Africa. Another last 16 exit for Korea. Beaten by the eventual semi-finalist Uruguay. Baek Sung-dong trying to get away from Ngonga. One dummy too many, maybe, by Kim Chang-soo. this way and that, this way and that. Obiang got a touch of the ball, but also clipped the fullback's leg. Free kick, Korea. Ki Sung-yung to whip it in. Park Chu-young deciding just to duck out of that, settling for the resultant throw. Really good crowd at Wembley for this one. At the moment, not that much to get excited about, but that can quickly change. Aubameyang. Meyer, who's strong. Aubameyang, plenty back in red. Clearance by Kim Chang-soo. Lovely layoff, and it can go on one again. Keeper's come a long way to deal with this, and nonchalantly done by Didier Ovono. Great play. Right to the edge of his area. Mindful of the bounce, because Park Chu-young was deemed onside when the ball was played through. And had Ovono not come out to command that situation, the Arsenal striker could have been in business. Kim Bo-kyung. Park Jong-woo. ...58 caps for Gabon senior side, Didier Ovono. He's their only overage player. Kim Chang-soo. Up goes Meyer, beaten to it by Hwang Seok-ho. Undong. Madinda. Zambe, on by Obiang, and turned behind by Kim Yong-kwan, under pressure by Pierre Aubameyang. Gabon will settle for the corner, their first of the game. Keeper thought about coming for it and thought against it. Axel Meyer couldn't control the header. Well, his expression and his posture has barely changed since kickoff. Claude Mburuno, former senior coach of the Gabonese side, now the new technical director for the Gabon Football Federation. In the opposite dugout, Hong Myung Bo. Obiang and Ngonga. Kim Bo-kyung brought down. I think both of the Gabonese players got a nick there. Kim Yong-kwan. Well, it's a lovely pass. Yun Suk-young taking it in his stride, but the touch was a bit heavy. Busugu wants to get distance on this. Kim Jang-soo. Chasing is Park Chu-yong. Just about kept it in. Baek Song-dong. Yun Suk-young with a chance to centre. Decent ball in and just wide. It's a good effort from Koo Jae-chul. Lovely delivery from the left back, and the captain just trying to steer this and at the far post. It's a lovely effort, lovely delivery too. And Koo Jae-chul is a matter of a foot or two away from bringing us the opening goal. Ngonga for Gabon. Korea started with a goalless draw against Mexico at St. James's Park. It was a game there. They had the better opportunities, but couldn't put them away. And followed that up with a 2-1 success over Switzerland at Coventry on Sunday. That was goalless two at half-time. Kim Jang-soo likes to bring it forward. Kim Bo-kyung. Mexico, one of the two other teams in the group, and it's a Mexican wave we've got sweeping around the stadium now. Fans doing their bit to try and entertain themselves as the game continues to be a bit of a slow burner. If you've just joined us, the scenario is this: win or draw and Korea are through. They can even afford a narrow defeat by one goal, but if Gabon beat them by two, then it's the West Africans who will go through to the last eight rather than the Koreans. Park Chu-yong with a throw-in. Yun Suk-young, he's already delivered one really good ball. This one nowhere near as good, easily cut out by Busagu. Hopeful from Undong. Park Chu-yong's flick on, tied it up by Muladinda. Situation demands that Gabon have to find goals. Korea can afford to be cautious. A draw will suffice for them. They don't have to chase the game at all. The onus on Gabon to do that. Just haven't got going at all as yet. Forward by Nzambi. Meyer trying to get hold of it for Gabon. Now Madinda. Ngonga. just turned 19, Frank Engonga. And that looked like it was handball, but not spotted by the referee, Axel Meyer. Pass one, the shot is on here. Now Obiang takes over. Madinda. Obiang. That was travelling. But in the way was Ki Sung-yung. Far side is Stevie Nzambe. Ndumbu. Engonga. So strong. That's a lovely ball too. Aubameyang. Axel Meyer waits in the centre and it won't quite reach him. Well claimed by Jung Sung-ryong. That's the best move that Gabon have provided. Lovely run off the shoulder of the defender by Pierre Aubameyang. Teasing ball in two. And had the goalkeeper spilt that, Axel Meyer was on hand. Encouraging signs for Gabon. Obiang. Ndumbu. Madinda. Aubameyang. Engonga's in there again. This time the foul has been given. Well, it's a big afternoon for him in particular. The right back being asked to play in the centre of midfield. And without the influence of Merlin Tanjigora, he's got no help in that department. It's taken him 30 minutes to get to grips with the Koreans. And now he's showing signs of coming into his own. Here and there, there are pockets of support for the two teams. The vast majority of the crowd, strictly neutral. Here's Yun Suk-young. Koo Jia-chiol. That's a brilliant ball. Baek Suk-dong is in. Beautifully timed tackle by Mabikov Busugu. Had to get that right. And the referee felt that he did. Baek Suk-dong shaping to shoot. And that's a marvellously timed challenge by Busugu. Might have been a slight touch prior to it, but that challenge was perfect. Busugu, 21 years of age. One of the six in the starting lineup that are still playing club football in Gabon. Aubameyang. Baek Suk-dong. Flag is up. Kim Bo-kyung offside. Looked level to me. Looked to me as though Ndong, I think, was playing him onside. Park Chu-yong. Important foot in by Ndumbu. Now Obiang. Ndumbu. And then Engonga sportingly puts the ball into touch to enable Korea to get their physio on. Problem here for Baek Suk-dong. just stretching. And just rattled in to Alexander Ndumbu. Baek Sung-dong, 20 years of age, plays his club football in Japan. This is his first start. He's come on as sub in the previous two group games. Ndumbu, the substitute brought on for the stricken Merlin Tanjigora. Korea could win Group B, they could finish runners-up in Group B, or they could go out of Group B and out of the competition. Same could be said for Gabon. Unlikely that they'll win the group, but they could certainly finish second if they win this game by two clear goals. Seems unlikely at the moment. But there are signs that Aubameyang is beginning to play a part. This is Madinda. Aubameyang. Madinda tries to win that. Shot from distance from Engonga. Always clearing the crossbar. Shouldn't be scared to shoot. We'll call that a sighter. Gabon have only scored one goal in the competition so far, but had chances to score more in both of them. Hit the bar against Switzerland, had late opportunities against Mexico when they were one down. The final goal came in the last seconds. Obiang. Likes a dribble and wins the free kick, brought down by Kim Bo-kyung. Well, 6 minutes away from the end of 45 minutes, but I would strongly suggest we'll have at least two, if not 3 minutes of added time. This a real opportunity for Gabon. Pierre Aubameyang from a long, long way out. Still, coach Mburuno sits impassively. Pierre Aubameyang is good, but not that good. Maybe not quite as impassive as I first thought. Meyer. Madinda. Meyer again. Nicely done by Meyer. Not sure what the climax was about, but Nzambi will keep it in. Engonga. Good, powerful looking run. He's won another corner. Off Kim Chang-soo. And the crowd are enjoying this. Alexander Ndumbu with the corner. Aubameyang and Hwang Seok-ho not quite seeing eye to eye at the minute. It's a waste. I think his reaction along the lines of, what on earth was that? Four making darting runs in the penalty area, and that ball in is beyond all of them. Aubameyang. Jerry Obiang. Now Madinda. Useful effort. Well, Korea with one or two things to think about at the moment. Let's see what Levi Madinda was trying, just to try and bend it in. Jung Sung Ryong knew that it was drifting harmlessly wide. Oh, it's a lovely dummy. Koo Jae-chol just overran it, and it's cleared by Engonga. It's a shocking pass, and Engonga concedes the free kick. And then throws a glance at Emmanuel Andon, as if to say, what was that pass all about? Free kick Korea, 2 minutes from half-time. Ki Sung-yung to take. That's a lovely delivery. And Hwang Seok-hol just mistimed his jump. Timed his run to perfection. Dinda with the defending. Now Madinda. Park Chu-young. Near side, Baek Sung-dong, fouled by Undong. The Korean had long since breezed beyond the fullback by the time the challenge came in. Once again, the referee perfectly placed to blow for the foul. Ki Sung-yung to take. Almost an exact replica of the free kick of a minute ago, when his well-delivered ball found the head of Hwang Seok-hol. And the defender is in there again. Three extra minutes at the end of this first half. First half where the chief talking point has been the injury that brought this added time. But that might all change. It's Kim Bo-hyung. Gabon's throw. Engonga. Far side and Zambe. Meyer. Busugu. Maybe time for one last chance of a goal for Korea. Park Ju-chung waits in the centre. Yun Suk Young. And Busagu with time to clear. Madinda. Undong. Park Chu-young. Good enough challenge from Busagu. And that kind of sums up the first half, really. A half in fits and starts, but Gabon are going to have one last chance to break the deadlock. The foul on Pierre Aubameyang. And now the coach is out of the dugout. Now he wants to get an instruction on. Referee wants the wall back a few more yards yet. Jung Sung Ryong prowling his goal line. He's got six in his wall. And just see there, number 11, Axel Meyer of Gabon is right in the middle of it. He's being shoved out of it by the Korean players. Levi Madinda. This will be the last bit of action in this first half. Madinda ready for Gabon. The wall does its job. And there won't be time for the corner. There goes the half-time whistle. Another shake of the head by Claude Mbouronno. Gabon really haven't got going in that first half, but not helped by that early injury for Tanji Gora. Korea have carried the game to them without really testing Didier Ovono in the Gabonese goal. Just that one shot saved by the keeper from Koo Jae-kyol. But apart from that, chances have been few and far between. Half-time at Wembley. It's Korea 0, Gabon 0. Nil-nil at half-time at Wembley in this final game in Group B. Gabon's chances, they have to win this game by two, remember, have not been helped at all by that early injury to their key midfielder, Merlin Tanjigora, inside the opening 5 seconds. He's been replaced. Gabon took a while to get into any kind of rhythm. Korea have generally dominated the play, but just one real chance, Koo Jae-kyol, denied by Didier Ovono. Half-time, it's Korea 0, Gabon 0. Pete Martin. The computer's gone offline. Thank you. Welcome back to Wembley as the players emerge from the dressing rooms. Gabon 0-0 at the break with South Korea. Gabon, remember, having to make a very early change. Merlin Tanjigora limping off with what appeared to be an injury to his lower back region. It occurred within 15 seconds of the kickoff in the centre circle. He kind of fumbled on for a while, stumbled about, had two separate spells of treatment. Neither did the trick. And eventually he was replaced by Alexander Ndumbu. That is Pierre Aubameyang, the only goal scorer so far at the Olympics for Gabon. They need to find two goals to have any chance of making it through to the last eight. For Korea, a clean sheet will do for them. And they will be in the quarterfinals. Now it looks as though they've got a change up their sleeve. That is Nam Tee-hee, who started the first two games and will be coming on for the second half here. Making way is Park Jong-woo. Nam Tee-hee, who's just signed to play his club football in Qatar. The message in the huddle along the lines of 45 minutes away from the last eight. Nothing silly. And we're there. And if we can win this game, Korea will be in a very strong position to win the group. And that would mean that they would be back at Wembley for the quarterfinals. Korea in the red and blue strip get us back underway. Attacking the goal away to our right-hand side. They had the lion's share of the first half. 55% of the possession compared to Gabon's 45. Three shots on goal compared to none. Gabon did begin to look the part in the last 15 minutes. The onus on the Africans to get on the front foot and score two goals with no reply. Baek Sungdong. Getting it back from Kim Chang-soo. Korea's 4 points have come from a draw with Mexico and a victory over Switzerland. At the football tournament at the Olympics for the 8th time, the farthest they've ever gone is the quarterfinal stage. They've done that twice, 1948 and 2004. Last time out, 4 years ago in China, they were knocked out at the group stage. Here's Undong for Gabon. Aubameyang. Aubameyang, who plays his club football these days in France with Saint-Étienne, scored 18 goals last season. Was actually with the Milan youth side for quite a long spell. His father, Pierre, also a Gabonese international in his day, is now one of the chief scouts at the Italian club. Jung Sung Ryong with a long, long goal kick. First to it, Ngonga for Gabon. Acrobatically and athletically away by Busugu. Bit of a reshuffled Gabonese backline today. That's the Korean coach, Hong Myung-bo, who in his day played over 130 times for his country, including 4 World Cups, scored against Italy and Germany at the 94 competition. And the opposite dugout, Claude Mburuno. The technical director for the Gabon Football Federation, used to be in charge of the senior side, now looks after the younger section. Nam Tihi. Away by Busugu. The shot is on though for Koo Jae Chol. Korea's second corner. Ki Sung-yong. It's deep, they've got players over here, Korea. And slashing as he fell, clearing the crossbar, Park Chu-young. On a day when there haven't been that many opportunities, this needs to stay on target. Park Chu-young just losing his balance as it dropped. On target in the victory over Switzerland, the Arsenal forward. Kept in by Nzambi, who's got it back off Obiang. Nzambe for Meyer. Nice turn through the gap for Aubameyang. Just ran away from him. First real sign of the front two combining there. Neither could really get in the game in the first half, not helped by being starved of any decent service. And indeed, much possession until the half hour mark. Ndumbu. And Yun Suk-young, who I think is a little bit too distressed by the challenge that came in on him by Ndumbu. Just watch here as the Gabonese midfielder just seemed to jump in a bit there. Contact made with the Korean's midriff. Winded perhaps as much as anything else. Mayer's through ball here, just ran away from Aubameyang. It's an uphill challenge for Gabon to beat this well-drilled Korean side. Remember, they've not lost since November 2010. Gabon, well, it's one step at a time. Get one goal, it might just inspire you and drive you on to get the second. Surprise winners of the inaugural African Under-23 Championships that provided the qualifying campaign for teams from Africa. In the final, they beat the hosts Morocco. They were one down in that game, but came through to win it 2-1, so they have spirit and determination within their ranks. Forward by Engonga. Mayer was offside. Our referee, Pavel Kralovec, from the Czech Republic. Quiet game for him so far. Mzambe with time to clear. And given that time that he had, maybe Mayer's entitled to receive a better pass. Kujay Chol. That's a lovely through ball. And now half an opportunity here for Baek Sungdong. Still not away. Nam Tee-hee for Korea. Here's the captain, Kujay Chol. Just ran away from Baek Sungdong. They can be neat in their approach, Korea. But so far at these games, they haven't found the finishing touch often enough. But on course to make the last eight as things stand at the moment. Could find themselves playing the hosts, Great Britain, in the quarter-final stages. Engonga arrives, stopped by Nam Tee-hee, looking for Park Chu-young. Yun Suk Young. Kim Bo-kyung, stopped by Dinda. Nam Tee-hee. Kujay Chol. Square is Kim Chang-soo. Nice football this from Korea. Didn't get the finish from Baek Sungdong. Turn neatly inside and away from Stevie Nzambi. Got two goals in the qualifying campaign to get Korea here. Foul conceded by Busugu. Free kick quickly taken. Kim Chang-soo. Baek Sungdong. Kim Chang-soo. Away by Dinda. Nam Tee-hee. Kim Chang-soo, Baek Sungdong, Lively starts the second half from him. Well, Avono wanted to release the forwards quickly, but didn't see any run of sufficient quality to launch one downfield. Gabon have to find a way of getting possession, because at the moment, Korea are finding it all too easily to retain it and knock it about with great comfort. No way through for Aubameyang. Good run forward here by Yoon Suk-yong. It'll come out as far as Baek Sung-dong. Baek Sung-dong! Well, he needs to hit the target from there, and he knows it. It came off Mullendinda, and as it reached Baek Sung-dong here, got away from Stevie Nzambe and needed to test Avono. Create space, can't find the finish. One goal will probably be enough for South Korea to win this, and might well give them the honour of winning the group. Nam Tee-hee looks a little bit too strong for the fullback Kim Chang-soo. Here's Ndumbu for Gabon. Madinda turning into trouble. Well, the pattern of the play in this second half is very similar to the pattern of play at the start of the first. Gabon struggling to get any kind of possession. Korea creating opportunities, but just not taking them. Ndumsu did well. He's done very well. He's got Obiang to his left. Well, he had more time than he realised, Obiang. Time to have a touch, take it closer, and pick out a colleague in white. And finally, Claude Mbouronno, who's been the picture of patience throughout most of the first half, is beginning to show the strain. 30 minutes to find two goals. 30 minutes to find, at the very least, a shot on target to test Jung Sung Ryong. Baek Sung-dong offside. Ji Dong-won is going to be brought on for South Korea. Mayer's got it back for Gabon. A foul by Nam Tee-hee. Obiang too strong again. Koo Jae-chul. Ki Sung-yong. Clipped by Ndumbu. Now, a yellow card's going to be shown here to Ndumbu. I don't think for the foul, but for the petulant way in which he tossed the ball at the stricken Korea's player's head. It's a very soft yellow card and the first of the game. Free kick given for that, but watch what follows as Ndumbu picks up the ball and tosses it angrily at Ki Sung-yong. Kim Bo-kyung to make way for Ji Dong-won. Plays for Sunderland in the English Premier League. Third time he's come off the bench at this competition. Forward by Engonga. Obiang to chase. Goalkeeper always the favourite. Foul on Engonga. Quickly taken. Madinda. Now on Dong. On Dumbu. That's a nice ball. Baek Suk Dong, options right and left. Park Chu Young. Great support here from Kim Chang Soo. Mayer for Gabon. The game stretched for the first time all evening. Career quickly getting bodies behind the ball. Engonga. Obiang. The crowd desperate to cheer a goal for either side. No need to play that. It's a lovely move from Korea. Great energy from Kim Chang Soo. And he was inches away from finding Nam Ti Hee in the centre. Well crafted move. Kim Chang-soo. South Korea as a nation are already amongst the medals here at London 2012 at the start of play this morning. They'd picked up eight already, three of those gold medals in shooting, archery and judo. Reaching the last eight would be an achievement for their footballers, but get a medal, that would be outstanding. Ndumbu. Engonga. Madinda wants to shoot this. Took a deflection against the post. And I'm not sure that Jung Sung Ryong would have got it anyway. Kept in by Aubameyang. Well, it's the closest we've come to a goal for Gabon. Madinda here, not closed down quickly enough. Just clipped off the defender eventually. And that took it away from the goalkeeper. And onto the post. Will that give Gabon encouragement to push a little bit more for the goal that they desperately require? They need two, but one would be a start. It's the last bit of action for Levi Madinda. Might be the end of his Olympic Games. In his stead, coming on, Samson Umbingwe. hearty round of applause for Levi Madinda. Samson Mbingwe, another 20-year-old. A late call-up into the squad. Got 7 minutes against Mexico. We'll get a little bit longer than that today against Korea. Can he find the goals? Kim Jang-soo. Space here for Nam Tee-hee. Two weight in the box in red. Lovely little touch. Busagu slides into good effect for Gabon. Ndumbu. Axel Meyer. Ndumbu. This was desperately close. Just see the deflection there. That took it onto the post with the goalkeeper sprawling to his left. Just came off Ki Sung-yung. Got another injury problem here, Gabon. Mabikov Busugu, who stretched in to clear as Korea looked dangerous a minute or so ago. Might have just stretched a muscle or two. Well, they are down to the bare bones, Gabon. They've only got one outfield sub left. And Alan Nono is not a defender. Nicely taken by Nam Tee-hee. No way through for Ji Dong-won. Koo Ja-kyo. Kim Chang-soo. As for Gabon at these Olympic Games, by the way, they've also got competitors in the boxing and the 100 metres. They've never won a medal at the Games before. This is Kim Chang-soo. Did well to keep it in. Swept away by Dinda. He's limping, but he's going to have to carry on, Busagu. Can see a heavy strapping on that left leg of his. Not moving at all freely. Kim Chang-soo. Baek Sung-dong. Kim Yong-kwan. Yun Suk-yung. Ji Dong-won. Nam Tee-hee, Ki Sung-yung, Kim Chang-soo, Ji Dong-won, pass one, pass two, good looking ball in, just too strong for Park Chu-young. Oh, it's lovely work here by Ji Dongwon. Got away first from Busagu, then steps inside on Dong, floats it in, and Park Chu-young just couldn't quite grow enough. Oh, agonisingly close, just a touch with his forehead, and that was 1-0. The two Premier League players almost combining for the opening goal. Gabon looking tired. This is Nam Tee-hee. Nam Tee-hee and Park Chu-young unable to take it in his stride. Not the greatest last 60 seconds for the Arsenal striker. There you go. Couldn't get his feet right. Nil-nil will do for Hong Myung-bo and Korea. But it might not be enough for them to win the group. Busagu playing almost on one leg at the moment, doing enough to stop Nam Tee-hee. But it's a corner to Korea. Third of the game. Just sense that it's in the air, a goal for Korea. The corner is deep and it hasn't been cleared yet. Dinda's got it away from the penalty area now. Nam Tee-hee, Baek Sung-dong, throwing off Nzambi. Kim Chang-soo. Chance to cross now. And Ndumbu for Gabon. Well, in recent years, African nations have done well at the Olympic Games. 4 years ago, Nigeria were runners-up to Argentina. It was Nigeria who won the first African gold in football in 1996, something Cameroon achieved 4 years later. But it looks as though this is the end of the road for Gabon. Their first taste of the Olympic Games. Looks like it will end at the group stage. Nam Tee-hee for Korea. Blocked by Ebonga. Who's thread that one through from Ndumbu, looking for Aubameyang. Long way out for Mbingwe. Baek Sung-dong. Ji Dong-won. Oh, beautifully founding. Well, this is the last change for Gabon. 15 minutes to go. Alan Nono. It's bleach hair replacing dyed hair as Axel Meyer makes way. Alan Nono, 19 years of age, missed a great chance late on to equalise against Mexico. Aubameyang, Nono. Instant impression, not instant reward. Well, had that chance late on gone in against Mexico, it would have been a different picture for Gabon. It's well wide in the end, that, from him. Korea's throw. Nam Tihee. Ngonga, too robust. Full of remorse and apology. Kujie Chol gets what he wants, a free kick. Ki Sung-yung will take. 30 minutes from time, still awaiting the first goal at Wembley today. Towards that back post. And the header from Kim Yong-kwan, safely gathered by Avono. Now a bit of space for Pierre Aubameyang. It's on target at least. From one end of the pitch to the other. Up goes Nono. Undong. Undumbu. He's got away from his marker. Bakes Undong. Ji Dongwon, Park Chu-young in the centre. It was intended for him, it'll come down for Nam Tihee. Good tackle. And Zambe kept his feet well. And he's there again. Kim Chang-soo. Away this time by Dinda. Ngonga. Aubameyang. Taking on Hang Song Holt for pace. Oh, well, it was dropping at the last moment there. And Jung Sung Ryong taking no risks. Aubameyang centre caused him one or two concerns, and Gabon get themselves a corner. Ten minutes from time. Park Chu-young replaced by Kim Hyun-sung. Here's the corner. Mbingwe unable to get over it. Well, here's the brilliant defending by Stevie Nzambe, forcing Nam Tihee wide and then stopping him in his tracks. And here's Nam Tihee again. Over the bar from Ji Dongwon. Two subs have carried a threat since they entered proceedings in this second half for Korea. Aubameyang's foul. Korea nearly there. ...82 minutes played, and Gabon haven't really looked like scoring a goal. Now they've got to find 2 in 8 minutes, and a yellow card here for Jung Sung-ryong for taking too long in taking this free kick. Ji Dong-won, he's done brilliantly to keep it in. That should be Avono's, strong punch away. Yun Suk-young. And all the way back to the goalkeeper. Out by Busugu, collected by the left back, Yun Sung-yuk. Ki Sung-yung. This time it's Dinder away. Ji Dong-won, fouled by Nono. In comes the free kick. Attacking it far post was Kim Hyun Sun. Safely gathered by Avono. Ngonga for Gabon. Here's Steve Nzambi. In towards Aubameyang. Calmly done by Ki Sung-yung. It ends here for Gabon. Unless the most dramatic of conclusions to a game that we've seen so far. Gabon, who've barely had a shot on goal all game, need to score twice in the last 5 minutes. First to it is Aubameyang, it's too strong again. Well, they've not been overawed at this competition. They've been stubborn, difficult to beat, just haven't fashioned enough chances to make it out of this evenly balanced group. Ji Dong-won. Just too heavy for Baek Sung-dong in the centre. Foul by Mbingwe. Four to go. Our Korea about to register their second goalless draw of the competition. In comes the free kick from Ki Sung-yung. Away by Undong. miscontrol by Ji Dongwon. Ki Sung-yung, Koo Jae-kyo, Yun Suk-yung with a cross. Decent effort coming in from Kim Hyung-sung. Couldn't keep it down. It would have been a spectacular finish. He's only just come off the bench. It was behind him and it was high. Addressed it well, but unable to control the shot. It's a game that doesn't really deserve a goal of the quality that would have been. But a goal would be nice. And Zambia's won the free kick. Well, to be fair, the crowd have done their bit throughout the game to try and inspire either of these teams to put the ball in the back of the net. 2 minutes to find a goal. Stevia and Nzambi over the free kick. Plenty forward in white, and Nzambi puts everything behind that. Back Sung-dom shouts for a handball against Ngonga. Ji Dongwon. That's a foul. Korea's turn to have an opportunity of breaking this deadlock. Hong Myung-bo with the instructions from the sidelines. Ki Sung-yung to take. A goal now for Korea might be sufficient for them to win the group, and that might have one or two consequences. Delivery in not good enough, and Ndumbu getting it away. Nam Tee-hee. Ngonga climbed well, but was using the shoulders of Ji Dongwon to get extra elevation. So 3 minutes of added time. The crowd have stayed to the bitter end. Perhaps they know something. Kim Jung-kwon with the free kick. This is Kim Chang-soo winning the throw. It's a long one. Helped on. And then away by Busagu. No. No. And Nzambi to swing it in. It's behind Aubameyang. Lovely first touch from Nam Tee-hee, but Ngonga's reclaimed it for Gabon. This is Aubameyang. Gabon get the corner. Thierry Obiang has struggled to provide quality with his left foot all afternoon. He's got one last chance. The referee wants a word with Aubameyang and Hwang Seok-hol after they clash again. Obiang with the corner. Possibly the last chance of the game to bringing us a goal. Busagu. Obiang. It's a decent ball in. No celebration from Pierre Aubameyang. Finishes up on his backside. And Ndumbu. Ji Dongwon, and the referee blows for time. Stalemate at Wembley. Job done for Hong Myeongbo and Korea. They finish with 5 points out of a possible nine. A draw was good enough for them to make progress. They had the better of the chances that we saw today. In truth, there weren't many of those. Kim Hyun-kwon and Koo Jae-kyo going close in the first half. Kim Hyun-sung going close right at the end. Gabon battled bravely throughout. That fella there, Mabikov Busagu, finishing almost on one leg after his injury. Gabon gave it as good as they got, but just couldn't break down South Korea. And at Wembley, it finishes all square without a goal. South Korea nil, Gabon nil. So it's all over at Wembley then. It's all over in Group B. Neither side could produce a goal today, which is a great shame because terrific support for them today. Another huge crowd at Wembley. Gabon's Olympic adventure finishes here. It was always going to be an uphill task for them. Not only did they have to win, they needed to win by two clear goals to move above Korea in the table and make it into the quarterfinals, but they couldn't do that. Korea had the better chances, but they couldn't put their opportunities away either. And confirmation of the final Group B standings with the result from the other game, Mexico beating Switzerland, it means that Korea finish second in the group, and that means that they will play their quarterfinal at the Millennium Stadium on Saturday, where they will play the winners of Group A, and that quite easily could be the hosts, Great Britain. Further stats of proceedings today. No goals for either team. Korea dominating possession and having the more shots on goal. But Gabon's opportunity here today almost disappeared within the opening 15 seconds as their hugely influential midfielder, Merlin Tanjigora, went down with an injury that required instant treatment. And despite his best attempts and those of the medical staff, he could not continue. And it meant that they always struggled to get hold of the crucial midfield area. Engonga, the right back, was forced to play there. Ndumbu, who usually plays on the wing, was forced to play in the centre of midfield. And Ki Sung-yong and Park Jong-woo in the first half. And then Koo Jae-hyel with Ki Sung-yong in the second half just dominated that area. South Korea had the better chances, but didn't really test Didier Ovono. But even so, the Gabonese captain was the busier of the two goalkeepers by some distance. Jung Sung-ryang barely had a thing to do. second goalless draw for Korea. We can read into that that they are difficult to break down, but maybe to make further progress in this competition, they need to be more dangerous themselves in the final third. They've reached the quarterfinal stage at the Olympics for only the third time in their history, 1948, 2004, and now 2012. Can they go beyond the last eight? Whatever happens, they'll be staying here at the home of English football. Quarterfinal. And let's look back at what we've seen over the last hour and a half or so, as Korea took on Gabon in front of an excellent crowd. Here's the injury to Chan Ji-gora, and already Claude Mbourano feared the worst. As Gabon struggled to get hold of the midfield, opportunities came Korea's way. Avono producing several smart stops early on. Hong Myung-bo directing operations from the sideline as Korea looked to take charge of proceedings. Opportunities for Gabon, few and far between. That one there from Madinda. He was to come really close later on with this effort that deflected off a Korean defender and struck the woodwork. They needed to get the first goal, you sensed. Korea wide with that effort from the sub, Kim Hyung-sung. Both coaches frustrated on the sidelines as neither team could find a way through. And so, confirmation then, here at Wembley today. It finished Korea 0, Gabon 0. Korea go through to the quarterfinal stages. Gabon go home.